Another typical July afternoon here in Virginia, hot and muggy. Virginia's in a particularly good location to pick up plenty of moisture from the Atlantic Ocean and the Gulf of Mexico. And all that moisture is pretty good for things like corn, soybeans, or kudzu, but it can be kind of rough on people sometimes. Our bodies cool themselves by perspiration. As it evaporates, it carries away heat. This system works quite well in very dry air, but the high humidity in our summer slows down evaporation, and as the temperature rises, our natural air conditioning system starts to fall behind. Our internal temperatures can begin to rise to dangerous or even fatal levels. We have a way of keeping track of this combined effect. It's called the heat index. It's based on the temperature and the relative humidity. Increasing ill effects and levels of danger are associated with increasing heat index values. For example, a value of 90 degrees or above is associated with heat exhaustion. Above 105 degrees is associated with heat stroke. In addition, the very young and the elderly are particularly susceptible to the effects of heat and humidity. During the summer, most weather forecasts will include a reference to the heat index, and advisories will be issued when there are dangerous conditions expected. Now, if you want to learn a lot more about this, you can visit our website, climate.virginia.edu. And I'm Jerry Stenger with the Climatology Office at the University of Virginia, advising you to take it easy this summer.